alternating shares seem to be really nice. It is easy to establish convergence. This seems to be too good to be true, and unfortunately, if something related to shares seems too good to be true, then there is usually a pitfall somewhere. In the case of the alternating shares, we have the following problem. Even when the shares converges, the sum may depend on the order in which we add terms. In order to avoid this undesirable property, we need a slightly stronger version of convergence, absolute convergence. In this video, you will learn all about it. Series sum an is called absolutely convergent if the sum of the absolute values converges. Well, if you have a series which has only positive terms, then the sum of the absolute values is exactly the same of the original sum, so then convergence and absolute convergence are the same. So in case of positive terms, we are immediately done. So let's look what happens if we have positive and negative terms. Let's look at an example. Suppose we have terms minus 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by n squared. Let's look whether this series is absolutely convergent. Then we take the absolute value of the terms. Well, the n squared is always positive, and the minus 1 to the power n minus 1 equals either plus 1 or minus 1. Well, its absolute value equals 1. So the terms are 1 over n squared. Now we have to look at this new series. Well, we know it's a p series with p equals 2, which is bigger than 1, which means that it is convergent. So the sum of the absolute values of our original series is convergent. That means that our original series is absolutely convergent. Let's look at another example, which is almost the same. But now we have minus 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by n. Again, we take a look at absolute values. So we look at the absolute value of minus 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by n. The n is always positive because n starts at 1 and goes up. The minus 1 to the power n minus 1 absolute value is again 1, so we have 1 over n. However, the series sum from 1 to infinity 1 over n, it's a harmonic series, or p series, which with the p smaller or equal than 1. So we know that it is divergent. So the sum of our absolute values is not convergent, which means that our original series is not absolutely convergent. So, second notion. If a sum is itself is not absolutely convergent, but if the sum of the series is convergent, such a series is called conditionally convergent, CC. Well, can this happen? Yeah, we've already seen an example. Because this series over here itself is convergent, it's an alternating series, the terms decay to zero, which means that the sum is convergent. However, we've also seen that it is not absolutely convergent. A series like that is called conditionally convergent. So, a series can be convergent but not absolutely convergent. Or a series can be both. What about, can series be absolute convergent but not convergent? No, that's not the case. Convergence does not apply absolute convergence, but vice versa, it does. Absolute convergence is stronger than convergence. If a series is absolutely convergent, then it's also convergent. Why is that? We need to be a bit careful. Suppose we know that our series is absolutely convergent, then we know that the sum of absolute values is convergent. Now we look, we do a trick. We know that our an plus its absolute value, either an is positive, then an plus an absolute value is equal to twice the absolute value. So an plus its absolute value is smaller or equal than twice its absolute value. And or if an is negative, then an plus its absolute value equals zero. So an plus its absolute value is either equal to zero or to twice the absolute value. So in particular, it's in between the two. Now we can do the following trick. We can use a comparison test. We know the series over here has positive terms, and it's below this convergent series, which means that the series itself converges. And now we can write our original series as sum of this part over here, minus this one. And now we have a sum of two series, this one and this one, from which we both know that they converge. That's why we can split them up. So we can split them here and here. We have the difference of two convergent series, which converges as well. And that's why we know that our original series converges as well. You see, you have to do quite a lot of work, because infinite series are always dangerous. But now, we've really seen, if your series is absolutely convergent, then it is convergent. And we've also seen it does not necessarily hold the other way around. A convergent series may or may not be absolutely convergent.